Some of the best of fashion pieces by Filipino and Canadian designers will take Toronto's catwalk by storm in a first-of-its-kind gathering in June. No less than 70-piece runway pieces and a 30-piece retro collection exhibited from Francis Libiran's 100 Fashion Gala will be featured as the main event during the first Canada-Philippine Fashion Week. Well, the four-day fashion event will be held for the benefit of special children through the Cole Hope Foundation. Here to tell us more about the event, our executive producer of the first Canada-Philippine Fashion Week, Jeff Rustia, and fashion designer Francis Libiran. Hello and good morning to the both of you.
Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you for inviting us.
Well, thank you for being here. This is quite exciting because it's the first of its kind. I guess it started off in June. I guess we really have the meeting of two fashion worlds,
for
right?
For sure. We're creating a bridge between Canada and the Philippines, and it's a sharing of cultures, fashion, and also just a showcase of Filipino artistry and innovation. And we're so happy to have the iconic Francis Libiran showcasing his 100-piece collection.
It's a beautiful collection that I think we'll see some parts of, like little bits and pieces of it. But we won't spoil the surprise. Let's first talk about why you felt it was time to create this bridge between Canada and the Philippine fashion world.
You know, I grew up in Canada, but I've always been a very, very patriotic, very proud to be Filipino. So this was very natural for me to actually produce and organize the very first Canada-Philippine Fashion Week.
Uh-huh.
But you know, on a personal note, I was inspired last year when I came here to the Philippines for what was supposed to be a two-week vacation.
Uh-huh.
And it ended up being a four-month sabbatical. My son had passed away, Cole. The Foundation for Children with Disabilities that helps Filipino kids and Canadian kids is inspired by my late son, Cole. Cole Hope Foundation for Children. And this is an incredible event. This is a gift from Cole. And as a Filipino-Canadian boy, what a great way to showcase the Filipino culture and also the Canadian talent and the Filipino talent through the first Canada-Philippine Fashion Week.
Well, it's a wonderful way to keep Cole's memory alive.
For sure.
It's a wonderful way to keep and help other children with special needs, you know, realize their dream. And also, we talk about the meeting of the fashion worlds and the cultures. I mean, it's a lot of things that are kind of getting checked off in this four-day.
Exactly. And, you know, this is coming at a very appropriate time in Canada because, mm-hmm. you know, we are now officially 800,000 Filipinos in Canada, and they're saying, Census Canada is saying that within 5 years there's going to be 1 million Filipinos in Canada.
Ooh,
so this is a we're the third largest ethnic demographic in the country,
uh-huh.
and this is our time. Yeah. To really showcase our artistry.
Well, I hope that it doesn't become 800,001 with Francis going there in June and liking it too much or falling in love. But Francis, tell mm-hmm. us about the collection. Tell us about being part of this Fashion Week and what you wanted to exhibit.
You know what? I'm very honored to be part of this Canada-Philippine Fashion Week. I'll be showcasing my 100 collection from the 100 year of Manila Hotel.
Uh-huh.
So I'll be showcasing modern Filipiniana pieces, like let's say the Mother of Pearl collection, uh-huh. the Calado, and the Spanish lace collection. So everything representing the Philippines.
All right, well, we're seeing three pieces, three beautiful creations of yours on the screen right now. I guess we'll go from left to right, Francis. Tell us about each piece.
Okay, for the plum, it's made out of mother of pearl. What we did is we laser cut the mother of pearl, the shell itself, and we made it as an embellishment for the gown. I think it's very Filipino.
Mm-hmm.
And for the second one, it's called calado. It's made out of piña fabric. And the calado is, the embroidery you see is, it's called inuot. It's like,
inuot.
Yeah, uh-huh. like the one you used in the Santo Niños.
Oh.
It's embroidered, but it's embossed.
Oh, I see.
But
okay.
The thread is more of like a natural fiber.
So there's really, I mean, and just in this piece alone, you can really see a lot of the culture
yes.
that is behind these pieces.
Well, it's a different approach because it's not your usually embroidery. You
okay.
know, I made it into a different technique, like making it emboss.
Where do you get the inspiration to to do these things to I guess, take it to a different level?
I guess I just want to innovate whatever it is here in the Philippines and try to make it like it has an international appeal. You know, it's wearable, not only Filipinos can wear it, but everyone.
Well, it's beautiful. We have two pieces. We have one left as well. Tell us about, I love this one.
Yeah, that's my favorite.
Yeah, this was my favorite when they were putting it up on the mannequins.
So this is black and nude. I made it really sheer. That's why it's so sexy. It's just covering certain parts of the body.
I know. You can only imagine.
It's kind of revealing. And it's made out of Spanish lace and embroidery combined. I made use of black crystals to highlight the embroidery.
That's absolutely beautiful. This is all part of the 100 collection, right? Other things that we should look forward to from those pieces, maybe not the ones that we have here in the studio, but any other
stealers? I'll be featuring as a finale, a wedding gown made out of embroidery too and natural materials from the Philippines.
Something to very much look forward to. We're actually seeing the details of the Spanish lace
yeah.
gown.
And embroidery.
Right? Is there a name to this, Francis?
Well, we just call it the Black and Nude Collection.
We'll just call it the Black and Nude. everything.
As you can see, Francis really knows the woman's body. And this is Filipino haute couture at its best.
That's right. I mean, having worn your pieces before, it's amazing how it just makes you feel so much more beautiful. And it actually really fits so well to your body. I'm like, I didn't fit this, but how does this fit so well?
And great. Aren't you just so proud to be Filipino?
Yeah.
Yeah, very much so. When you see these creations and you wear it,
world
you feel
class.
Even more. All right, let's talk about some of the other things that we can also look forward to in for the Fashion Week. And what is it that you really want people to walk away from after the 4 days?
You know what? I think this is truly an event that transcends beyond fashion. It's about showcasing Filipino culture, Filipino heart, and pride. It is a dazzling week, as you know, on Filipino style and entertainment, and of course, philanthropy.
Yes, that's right. What is, I guess if you guys could both appeal to our viewers to get even more, to be more part of what's going on in the future and...
Well, I think that, you know, the Filipino fashion is, as you can see from Francis Libiran's work, is truly at a global level. Huh. And I think what we're exposing here at the very first Canada-Philippine Fashion Week is truly the artistry and the creativity of the Filipinos that we're so proud of.
Well, it's nice. Sometimes I feel as if there is a divide between, you know, Filipinos here and the homeland and those abroad. There becomes a little bit of a gap because the cultures tend to, I mean, I speak from coming from that culture or the Western culture as well, and you kind of feel like there's a gap between here in the homeland versus maybe Filipinos abroad, and this is nice because you're able to kind of connect. There's no competition between who is going to be exposed to other things or where we are in the fashion industry. This is really, hey, let's take what we have here, let's take what we have here.
You know what, Ginger, right now, the Filipino designers is going to on in a different level we're trying to penetrate the international market.
Uh-huh.
You know, we try our best on our own, you know, to contact stylists abroad and feature our work.
And you've done so, I know, of course, with America's Next Top Model, you've done so repeatedly, actually, Francis. How big of a challenge is that? Where do you think, that the global market is in opening its doors to the Philippine fashion?
You know what? Filipino designers are very innovative when it comes to fashion. That's why our talent is being shown around the world. You know, we just need a venue like the Canada-Philippine Fashion Week to open that for us.
And you know, we're calling all our fashion favors as every buyer in Canada, from the department stores, Sears, Target, Renfrew, The Bay, you know, they're gonna be coming to this event, and you know, we're really showcasing the talent, and also to look to the Philippines as you know, their next destination for buying clothes.
That's wonderful. All right, and other information as to the Co-Hope Foundation, maybe if people are interested in making certain donations, maybe not through the Fashion Week. But
sure, they can definitely donate through the www.colhope.com. And yes, this is a wonderful event that's going to help children with disabilities in the Philippines and in Canada.
All right, well, I congratulate you guys so far already. Pinoy Fashion takes over Canada. May the memory of of coal. Live.
Thank you.
Live
thank
you long.
Live very, very long.
Live on forever, actually. Thanks again, Jeff and Francis. Have a safe flight. Have a safe flight out,
you
guys.